Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Early this morning or yesterday, depending on your time zone, SpaceX launched their first mission of the year with Starlink 7-9.
One, ignition, and liftoff of Falcon 9.
The booster which launched this mission, B1082, then landed successfully for the first time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Coming up later today, we can hopefully expect to see another Falcon 9 mission launch. The Ovson 3 mission is currently scheduled for today, Wednesday 3rd at 11:04 PM UTC or 6:04 PM EST. Then later in the week and into next week, we can hopefully expect to see a couple of Starlink missions. The Starlink 635 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 7th at 12 PM UTC or 7 AM EST. Then just hours later, we could expect to see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 710 mission is currently scheduled for Monday 8th at 3:19 AM UTC or Friday 7th at 10:19 PM EST. Regarding the Starlink launch, we saw at the start of the video, the payload contained the first direct-to-cell Starlink satellites, and SpaceX posted this information. They said the 6 Starlink satellites on this mission with direct-to-cell capability will further global connectivity and help to eliminate dead zones. Musk posted some information in relation to what SpaceX posted. He said this will allow for mobile phone connectivity anywhere on Earth. Note, this only supports around 7 megabytes per beam, and beams are very big, so while this is a great solution for locations with no cellular connectivity, it's not meaningfully competitive with existing terrestrial cellular networks. SpaceX's VP of Launch gave some information on what we can expect from SpaceX in terms of launches this year. He said, "We are aiming for 144 launches in 2024, 12 per month. The launch system pad's recovery flight hardware needs to be capable of 13 per month so we can play catch up when planned maintenance debacles and weather inevitably slow us down." There is an article about India selecting SpaceX to launch a satellite. It says the commercial arm of India's space agency ISRO announced January 2nd it will launch a large communications satellite later this year on a SpaceX Falcon 9, further underscoring SpaceX's dominance in the global launch market. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. Here's a look at the work going on to expand Star Factory. Ship 30 was seen lifted onto the thrust simulator in the high bay. Ship 30 was also rolled out to Massey's test site to begin its test campaign alongside Booster 12. After the static fire test, Booster 10 was removed from the mount and placed on the transport stand. Booster 10 was then also moved back to the production site for some work. Due to inconsiderate parking, they only just managed to get it down the road. Taking a quick look at the Cameron County website, nothing has changed. SpaceX still have possible closures for today, Wednesday 3rd, and tomorrow, Thursday 4th. There is also a temporary road closure scheduled for tomorrow, hopefully for Booster 10 to be rolled out again. As always, I have to say thanks to Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.